This is the SAP Developer News for October 2nd, 2025.
Hey everyone, week one of Devtoberfest is almost over. If you want to check out what activities we've planned for week two, head over to the community, to the Devtoberfest group, and look out for the blog post, Devtoberfest week two activities. See you there.
I'm here with Pepper, a flat coat retriever, to announce Pettoberfest, where you can upload a picture of your pet, or your favorite zoo creature, or stuffed animal, or any furry friend you fancy. Just upload the picture as a comment to my blog post. In addition, use that picture as the basis for an AI-generated image of your pet. For example, here's Pepper helping me with my Devtoberfest crosswords and wearing her favorite hat. Be creative both in the setup and the style. Pettoberfest this year coincides with World Animal Day, so you can also upload a picture of yourself taking part in any animal welfare project. For example, renovating a stray cat hotel or walking to raise money for your local ASPCA. If you upload a picture, you will win oodles of points for the Devtoberfest grand prize. So I'm looking forward to seeing a picture of your pet.
Good news for all you cat fans. The rest of the session recordings from Recap 2025 are now online on YouTube for your queuing and viewing pleasure. Now, we already had the recordings of the sessions from the Blue Room track on the Recap Unconference YouTube channel. And now, after getting hold of the recording from the Audimax Theatre, we've got the sessions from the Yellow Room track cut and organized into individual videos, and they're in a playlist for you as well. The playlist follows the agenda order. And yes, we processed everything with a little bash script and everything on the command line. The future really is terminal.
The scavenger hunt event runs across multiple weeks of Devtoberfest. I hope you already figured out the three clues we gave out and you have a 12-digit hexadecimal number with you. If not, you may pause this video and check out the clues we released earlier from the main blog post on the scavenger hunt and come back for the fourth clue. For the fourth clue, we can explore some GitHub repositories as the clue is hidden in one of the repositories. Many of you may be aware of the SAP GitHub org SAP samples. It contains sample code, TechEd tutorials, CodeJam material, and hundreds of repos from which you can learn about ABAP, CAP, Build, and other SAP-related technology. Among the various repos, take a closer look at the SAP BTP AI Best Practices repo to find the two-character clue. This repo contains best practices, sample implementations to build AI-powered applications, and serves as a practical guide for developers looking to implement enterprise-grade AI solutions using SAP AI services and integration with generative AI models. To find the clue number 4, you don't have to clone the repo. You can look around the repo, access various tabs, search within the repo for some common terms related to Devtoberfest like build, ABAP, CAP, AI, etc. Happy hunting.
Before we dive in, a quick note. Our cat Felicia decided it was the perfect time for a nap, so she's not joining today. But I'm here, and there is plenty to share. We've just released the third SAP HANA Cloud update of 2025, packed with meaningful advancements. Here are a few highlights I've personally chosen. Vector embedding SQL functions now supports the generative AI hub, helping you integrate different models more easily. JSON is now a native data type in the document store, simplifying work with the unstructured data. Single sign-on for data lake files enhances security and accessibility. And with Joule in SAP Build Code, you can generate SQL from natural language, making development faster and more intuitive, and you can feel like a web coder now. For all the details, check out the dedicated blog post or the product team's teaser video. If data modeling is your focus, don't miss Jan Zwickel's deep dive post on the latest in graphical view modeling. He also spoke at Devtoberfest this week. Recordings are already available if you missed it. Finally, mark your calendar for next Thursday as well, as Christoph Morgan will explore developing AI-driven SAP HANA Cloud applications live at the Devtoberfest. It's a great chance to see these features in action. Let us know what stands out to you.
If you're in the India region, we've got an interesting opportunity for you to join the SAP TechEd On Tour in Bangalore coming up at the end of November. The community talk call for speakers is now open. If you're interested in sharing your experience or your knowledge about a particular topic in the SAP space, this is your opportunity to get a free lecture-only ticket to the SAP TechEd On Tour taking place in Bangalore. You only have until October 10th to submit your session proposal, so be sure to act quickly. We look forward to seeing you at TechEd Berlin, as most of the developer advocates team will be there. We'll be cheering you on and helping mentor you for your presentation as well. So this is a great opportunity for anybody looking to get a ticket to TechEd On Tour Bangalore and to share their knowledge at the event. So look forward to seeing you there.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the Developer News. UI5Con 2025 in Bangalore is going to happen in December, and the call for proposals is now open. You could submit your session proposal until October 31st. There is quickfire presentations around 20 minutes long, in-depth sessions 40 minutes, or longer hands-on workshops. Definitely check that out if you want to have a session at UI5Con in Bangalore. Also related to UI5, there is a new version of the SAP UI5 Roadmap Explorer with some interesting items on there. Regarding AI, obviously, there is new AI-related controls and also interesting MCP items. So definitely check that one out if you are interested in SAP UI5. All right, hope to talk to you soon. Bye.